Welcome children to yet another online class. Let's see what we are going to see in today's class.
Hey, Dolly.
Hey, Bailey.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
That's nice. What are you up to?
Nothing much, just thought of taking a walk in the park.
Wow, that's awesome. What made you do that?
Well, today's climate seems to be very good, and so I thought why not go for a walk?
You mean the weather?
Yes, isn't it the same, both climate and weather?
I'm sorry to say this, but it's not the same.
Then what's the difference?
That's what we're going to see in today's class.
Atmosphere. Earth is the only planet in the solar system with an atmosphere that can sustain life. Children, can you imagine life without air on Earth? Definitely the answer would be no. Life is impossible without air on the earth. Air refers to the earth's atmosphere. The atmosphere is the layer of gases around the earth. These gases are held closer to the earth by the gravitational attractions. Composition of the atmosphere, or what the atmosphere is made of. Atmosphere is the mixture of gases, water vapor and dust particles in different proportion. The atmosphere of the earth is composed of nitrogen 78%, oxygen 21%. These are the permanent gases of the atmosphere. They contribute 98% of the total composition. The remaining 1% is occupied by argon, carbon dioxide, neon, helium and hydrogen. Water vapor is also found in the atmosphere. Atmosphere plays a very important role in predicting weather phenomena. The other solid particles present in the atmosphere are dust particles, salt particles, pollen grains, smoke, volcanic ashes, etc. The presence of oxygen in the atmosphere is important for living organisms. Carbon dioxide absorbs heat and keeps the atmosphere warm. Nitrogen behaves like a diluent. Diluent is a substance used to dilute something. And the ozone, which protects our planet Earth from ultraviolet rays, that is UV rays. Now we are going to see the layers of the atmosphere. The atmosphere has five layers starting from the ground. Troposphere, the place where we live. Stratosphere, that houses the ozone layer. Mesosphere, this is a colder and lower density layer. Thermosphere, here the air is hot but very thin. Exosphere is the top layer, which is above the thermosphere. Let's see about each layer one by one. Troposphere. This is the first layer and the lowest layer of the atmosphere. It starts at the ground and ends somewhere between 0 to 18 kilometers. Here the temperature decreases with increasing height, and hence it is called weather-making layer. Weather like rain, snow, thunder and storm occur here. The upper limit of the troposphere is called as tropopause. The next layer is stratosphere. This is the next layer up. It starts at 18 kilometers and ends at 50 kilometers. It is referred as ozonosphere. It has sufficient ozone to block most ultraviolet radiation from the sun. In this layer, the temperature increases with the increase in height. Large jet planes fly here. The upper limit of the stratosphere is called stratopause. The next layer is mesosphere. This starts at 50 kilometers and ends at 80 kilometers. Winds in this layer are very strong. The temperature here decreases with increasing height. Radio waves, which is transmitted from Earth, are reflected back to Earth from here. Meteors nearing the Earth gets burnt here. The uppermost limit of the mesosphere is the mesopause. Thermosphere, this is the fourth layer of the atmosphere, which is directly above the mesosphere. Thermosphere starts at 80 kilometers and ends at 600 kilometers. The name thermosphere is taken from the Greek word thermos, means heat. It has high temperature because it absorbs X-rays and ultraviolet rays from the sun. Here the temperature increases with an increasing height. Ionosphere is a layer of thermosphere that contains ions and free electrons. The composition of gases in the lower thermosphere is more or less uniform and is called homosphere. The composition of gases in the upper thermosphere is uneven and is called heterosphere. The uppermost layer of the atmosphere is exosphere. This is also the most distant layer of the Earth's atmosphere. It is the planet's first line of defense against sun's rays. This layer protects the planet Earth from meteors, asteroids, and cosmic rays. Now we are going to see about weather and climate. Now let's know the two terms that are related to the atmospheric condition. One is weather and the other one is climate. What is weather? Weather is the condition of the atmosphere over a short period of time. Whereas climate is the average weather of a place over a period of many years. Weather changes very often. Let's see the difference between weather and climate. Weather changes very often. It is more or less, climate is more or less permanent. Weather, different types of weather condition in a day. And in climate, almost the same type of climate. Study of weather is called meteorology. Study of climate is called climatology. There are many factors that influence weather and climate. They are distance from the equator, altitude, nearness to the sea, nature of the prevailing winds, mountain barrier, cloud cover, ocean currents, natural vegetation. Let's look into each in detail. Distance from the equator. The most important climatic control is latitude, or how far one is from the equator. If you live closer to the equator, the climate will be warmer since the sun's rays fall vertically on the equator. Thus, the places which are far away from the equator brings cooler climate. Next one is altitude. This refers to the height above the sea level. As we move from the surface of the earth to the higher altitude, the temperature decreases. The temperature decreases at the rate of 6.5 degrees Celsius per kilometer, and this is called normal lapse rate. So places at the higher altitude have a lower temperature. It's colder and drier. The next factor is nearness to the sea. The climate of the place varies according to its nearness or proximity to the sea. The sea affects the climate of a place, like coastal areas are cooler and wetter than inland areas. Places near the coast experience equable climate due to the influence of the winds from the sea. Next factor is nature of prevailing winds. The wind changes the climate of a place based on from where they blow. When the winds blows from warmer region to, it makes the place warm. When it blows from colder region, it makes the place cool. Let's see what is onshore winds and offshore winds. Onshore winds is the one that blows from the sea towards the land. On the other hand, offshore wind is the type of wind that blows from the land towards the sea. This onshore winds cause rainfall and makes the place cool, but the offshore winds brings dry weather. Next is mountain barriers. Mountains does affect climate a lot. Mountain act as a barrier for the blowing winds. Sometimes they prevent the entry of the cold winds into the country or the escape of mountain winds. Let us see what is windward side and leeward side of the mountain range. Windward side is the side of a mountain which faces the prevailing wind on the other side where the wind hits the mountain. This side receives rainfall. It is heavy and always very green. The leeward side. The other side of the mountain, which is sheltered or protected from the wind, it is the drier side and receives very low rainfall. The next one is cloud cover. Cloud cover is the most important condition affecting the amount of radiation reaching the Earth's surface. Clouds prevents the entry of the heat to the Earth's surface. So the areas with cloudless sky has very high temperature and is like a desert. Areas under cloudy sky has low temperature. Ocean currents. It is the movement of ocean water. Ocean currents can increase or reduce temperature. Let us see what is warm ocean currents and cold ocean currents. Warm ocean currents warm the air above it, which in turn warms the nearby coastal areas. Cold ocean currents cools the air above it, which cools the nearby coastal areas. The last one is natural vegetation. Temperature and humidity are the main factors which determine the extent of vegetation. The trees release water vapor into the air and makes it cool. The forest areas have lower range of temperature throughout the year. Hope you all enjoyed the lesson, children. For better understanding, I want you all to go through pages 180 to 184. I also encourage you to watch the enrichment video. Goodbye, children.